This is Dr. Masters thanking you for clicking on to today's mini consultation. There's an expression that's been around a long time. When someone stops to speculate how something will turn out in their life, in such areas as employment, career, a health issue, a relationship, to name just a few areas. The expression, which definitely is a truism, is time will tell. So do you have to wait to see how things will turn out? Most people will have to wait. There are a few souls who have an appreciation of the hidden spiritual realities of life, who realize that the passing of time is illusionary, and that in truth there is but one eternal moment of time, where past, present, and future are as one. The universal God consciousness within the human mind is eternal consciousness. The closer a person is to the inner presence of the eternal, the more they are sensitive to all facets of the one eternal moment, and thus more likely to have more of a sensing of how things turn out. For in fact, one eternal moment has already taken place in what they are thinking about or contemplating in that moment. It is already so. With this in your thoughts, let us turn inward. I turn inward to the very center and nucleus of my mind, that Christ mind conscious point of contact where my soul is in an eternal state of oneness with the mind and spirit of God, here in the light of higher consciousness within myself. Let me recognize that time indeed will tell if this is all that I have an awareness of, that if all that I believe is all that I see and perceive through my outer five senses, then indeed I will have to wait it out to see how things will turn out. On the other hand, as mystics, sages, seers, enlightened philosophers, theologians through the years have discovered, there is really but one eternal moment where the past, the present, the future are as one, where everything that we think is going to be already is. Everything that can be has already happened. By drawing close to God's presence within ourselves through daily meditation and the giving up of our personal ego and will to God's presence and will, we then become more a part of an awareness of that one eternal moment and what it contains. And in so doing, we are more sensitive then to that portion of that one eternal moment that contains the question and the answer of how something will turn out, because it already has. For this realization of another reason to draw closer to the presence of God within oneself, we give thanks, we let it be so, and so it is. May God bless you and those you love today and this eternal moment of always.